cometh into thy kingdom. And Jesus said unto him, verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. The word of God. Let us pray. Father, help me now. Move me out the way. I need you. God, I'm begging and I'm pleading. I need you so much. God, you get the glory because I want to know what to do with the glory. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
I had two titles I was struggling with too, so I'll just give them to you. I am home, so forgive me. So you pick which one you like. The first one would be, forget about them and you go for yours. Forget about them and you go for yours. Or for someone else, the blood still works. Amen. Forget about them and go for yours. When the blood still works. This word has two views. It has the people view and what they think should happen. And then it has the God view of what you think or what he thinks should happen. And isn't it funny when we come into the house of God, when someone does something wrong, the people in the church tend to want to put their mouth on somebody on what they did wrong. Oh, Lord, help me, Holy Ghost. We don't care what God's view is. We don't care what God has to say about somebody, because people see you where you are right now. God sees you where you're going. But it's when you come into the house of God that people want to put a name to you. And usually the name they put to you is the sin that you have done. Oh, come on, don't act like you don't know what I'm talking about. Let there be a sister that comes down the aisle with 9 kids, 10 babies, daddy, and all she's telling them is we all going to get saved. We got a nerve that want to talk about who came down the aisle. How dare you talk about who came down the aisle, especially if we know what sin somebody has done, and they want to cry in church. Well, how they going to cry? Because what do they look like doing that for? Because look, they just so messed up and so sinful. We don't even care what the view of God is. Because the criminals next to Jesus, they had a name. They got a name criminal. And guess who was in the crowd? The people were happy that they were there. But see, in one version it calls them malefactors. In another version it calls them criminals. It's kind of confusing to me, but that's because that's what people do. See, they got caught and exposed. That's why they was on the cross. But I wonder how many people in the crowd that was watching on the cross got caught but didn't get exposed. Oh, y'all will get that later. Because see, it's the difference of when you get caught. Oh, Holy Ghost, help me. But it's another thing when you get caught and exposed. Because we get arrogant if we get caught and don't get exposed. See, some of you better be happy, Lord help me, that the person in your home didn't go run the pound, tell the pastor when they caught you to expose you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Some of you better be glad that you did not get exposed by what you did. But I wonder what would happen if the Lord had an exposed Sunday. Oh, Lord, what would church be like if you had to come in here with your sin wrapped around you? What would you look like if you had to come around with the sin wrapped around you? Your favorite sin that you like to do. Look, you can't cover it up because this is exposed. Okay. The Lord is exposing you. Hold on, I get dressed up. Right? Right. Oh, Y'all sit down, man. Y'all sit down. That's what I heard. And I did myself a favor. I put my sins above. Because when the Lord begins to wash you clean, you gotta be bound in sin. No, I'm talking. Maybe none of y'all. You never came to church all dirty and stinking. And you never came to church like, no. There's been times I came to the church ready to lay on the altar. Wipe the stuff off the communion table and just lay there. Because I'm like, Lord, if you don't clean me up. And this man was on the cross. He didn't care about Sister Lada Dottie. Brother, everybody. Deacon Reverend so-and-so. He said, Lord, I got to get mine. When are you going to get it in your mind that you got to get yours? I don't know where my son is at. He's supposed to come in at some point in time, but when he's going with it. So, let's just say the Lord starts wiping the blood off of him. Because this man couldn't enter the kingdom with sin. That's why he said today. Because while he was on the cross, there was a transformation happening while he was going on the cross. See, let's get spiritual for a moment. There was a supernatural transformation that the blood was starting to wash off the sins while he was on the cross. Anybody ever been here? The more you got closer to God, the more sin started to come off. The more you got closer to God, the more the sin started to come off. I don't know about you, but if you've been bound in sin and the sin starts to come off, you don't sit here. You can't sit still. Pastor, I can't understand how people sit still and sit there when the Lord has cleaned them up. I don't understand. My son's going to come in after blood drop. Come on. I learned something from him. Come on, cleaning me down. Now he's going to clean me down. And what he's doing with the blood, this is what the Holy Ghost is doing. It's taking the stuff off.
Next thing you'll know, you'll be standing next to God.